You know, man, people like bugging out. They're bugging out so much that, you know what? I'm gonna drink this beer with you. I don't care anymore. Give them a chance to leave again. More people to leave again.
Because we're drinking beer.
Because we're drinking beer. That's right. That's the type of people I've been attracting.
Some crazy shit.
Classy, Christian pressure, Shiva Shiva Ma Ma. Right? You know?
Oh, man.
And then they judge me.
That's it, bro. That's...
So now,
oh, man.
In solidarity, I'm drinking this beer, bro.
Yeah.
With you.
All right.
Because it's your fault. Because you got me started on this.
I appreciate it, man.
You got me started on this.
But I know you still love Ma, and I know you still love Krishna, and I know you still love Shiva, and I know it's all true still. It doesn't change. Because you just drank this beer with me.
Yeah, you know what? I don't understand.
The same.
But you know what? What I don't understand, you know, people talk about, the Christians talk about Balaram drank wine, right? But it's okay because he's the supreme personality of Godhead. And then Jesus drank wine.
Yeah.
But it's okay because he's the son of God. But what about all the people around them?
Oh,
they
no.
weren't drinking wine. And Jesus, he didn't turn wine into water. No!
Oh, no!
He turned water into wine!
Oh!
Alright? And in ancient Egypt, they used to drink beer too, so I don't know what these people are bugging out about. Talk to me, brother. Talk to me.
I think you know what it is.
What is it?
Is that people...
But
usually, I know for me anyway, man. I don't know about for them.
Talk to them, bro.
When I'm drinking... I feel I'm so relaxed, and I feel so, like, happy, and then I don't even really care about what I'm going to say or what I'm going to do. Like, I'm not thinking, like, oh, how am I going to present myself for other people so that, like, I don't hurt people's feelings.
So you're saying that beer has, you know, relaxes
it kind of relaxes me, so I can
you
just,
know what?
Just be me.
I'm going to lose a whole bunch of friends. That doesn't mean...
It's true, it does, man. You know what? I noticed because I feel like after a little bit of beer, and I don't overdo it, but when I have a little bit of beer, it's like, oh my God, you know? I'm not feeling so drunk, but I'm not feeling so tense either. So it's like now I'm just chilling.
Listen, people are bugging out, man.
Yeah, man.
You know, and I'm not down with that. But tell me, what about this Wall Street thing? What's going on? Because I don't even know what's going on.
Yeah, so what's happening now, and this is just from, I don't, you know, watch the news because it makes me depressed, bro, because it's just a lot of bullshit. But from different sources, from teachers, from friends, I've heard that what's going on now is that they're protesting Wall Street. And... because then finally people are waking up to the fact that the banks own the government.
No!
Banks own the
government. No! No!
And we can't vote against the banks. So now they're protesting because people who have had money and been raised having money are losing their things now. Because now they're like, well, wait a minute. The banks get bailed out, but we don't get bailed out.
This is an outrage.
Outrage.
This is preposterous.
So it's like, so a teacher of mine said, you know, a lot of these people can get exploited and, you know, they can be, a lot of these protesters can be used by, you know, by the establishment to, you know, for whatever, to make of them what they will.
But that's been going on forever, dude.
It's always the same thing.
So people are just beginning to wake up, you know.
Or like, I don't know, these people are the people that go to school. They go to school, they learn, they get a liberal arts education or whatever, and they learn, they hear all the things, they read all the things, but it's somehow it's not real. It's not real to them, man.
Not real. Why isn't it real? Why isn't it real? Tell me. Why isn't it real?
I feel like it's because they're like boxed in the system and they feel like, well, I don't know, man. I don't know, man. It's like, I think maybe for me.
Tell me, Eric.
Well,
tell me.
For me anyway.
Tell me.
It becomes, something becomes real when I really deep down inside feel that it's me
inside, right?
Inside, right? In me, it's me.
In there,
really me, yeah. And this is like, I can't say, yeah, this is real to me unless it's like inside my own inner voice is saying, this, yes, this is what challenges me. This is what really shakes me up. This is what really compels me, you know, really gives me life, you know. And maybe that's what it is. Maybe that's what it is. We go to school, we hear all this shit, we read all this shit, we take our tests, and then we're just like, we're done with it. And none of us are really thinking like,
we're blinded because we like to engage our senses too much. We like to engage our senses.
That's what it is. We're distracted, man.
We don't like to control our senses. This is what is occurring. We like to engage our senses, but you know what? People who control their senses too much are also full of nonsense.
They're still controlled by their senses.
Yes.
They're still controlled by their senses. I think for me, I mean, I on purpose did all the drugs, did all the things that were all like, you know, the things that they would say would mark you as a crazy person.
Forget about it. I was an all-star.
You know what? I wanted to find out if there was a point that I could get to where I was just going to be like, okay, well, really, none of this shit ever defined me and none of this shit is really what I really want.
That's true.
You know? So...
But let me ask you something. Like, people who are into Krishna, I've never stopped being into the science. The science of Krishna consciousness. The science! Not the religious dogma, the science! And you know what? Like, they see me, they'll probably see me drinking this Budweiser, listening to the Karnamrita, and they think, oh, but he's such a hypocrite.
Right.
You know what? So what?
The outer appearance.
We so what? Just,
right?
So what?
The outer appearance.
I ain't gotta stop. Right. I'm sorry.
No, you're right, man.
Am I really, like, people think I'm like this wingnut, but do I treat you badly?
No, not at all, man.
Abuse you,
you're
Eric?
You're my brother, man. You're my brother. You're
do I abuse you, Eric?
No.
Do I abuse you, Eric?
Abu Salon!
People are crazy, man.
Yeah.
People go crazy too. Like the other extreme, like this kid, this friend of mine, Pradeep Khatri, he said to me, go to this city, right, in Nepal, and all they do is they smoke weed like crazy and commune with Shiva.
Right.
And I said to him, wow, is that how you commune with Shiva? So I know there's bullshit on all levels.
All levels, man.
So I'm sorry, Pradeep, but you cannot just commune with Shiva by smoking weed.
Yeah.
Just smoke weed and enjoy it.
Yeah.
But you know what? Even too much of that is nonsense too.
Yeah.
Okay? But don't say that by smoking weed, you're communing with Shiva because you're chanting some mantras like an idiot, and then now you're communing with Shiva. That's nonsense. That's also nonsense. Excuse me while I take another swig of my sacred beer.
That's it, man. You know what? It's like we become attached to like extreme this, extreme that. You know, I've had my time of extreme, you know, left hand approach, extreme right hand approach, extreme middle hand approach. I will be a Buddhist and either turn to the left or the right. But you know what? The most narrow path of all, as far as I can see, is to be free to go anywhere you want. To be free to be as you are, wherever you are. It's just
well,
no.
You must, yeah.
No,
free.
No, you commune. You still
yeah,
know
commune.
That you commune.
Yes. Yes. This is like this. Jai Vrindavan. Rasika Mukunda. Money. Jacobinata. Rasika. Mukunda money. Mukunda money. The mind, the liberated mind. Right? This is, we're done. It's over.